In today's video, I'm going to be comparing Premiere Pro's Lumetri Color panel to the FilmConvert Nitrate plugin. Now, you may have seen several professional filmmakers talk about FilmConvert on YouTube. It's essentially a creative color grading tool that allows you to take your digital video and create creative color grades with film emulation and grain. Now, it does cost money, but you only have to pay once. It's not a subscription plugin. So I'm going to take a look at the similarities and the differences, and then color grade the same shot using FilmConvert Nitrate and Lumetri Color. So that way we can answer this question. Is it worth it to get the FilmConvert Nitrate, or is Lumetri Color good enough? Let's get into it. First of all, let's talk about the similarities. Both of them are creative color grading tools, so you can create a color grade using both. And second, they both have creative presets built in. So FilmConvert has their film stock presets, and Lumetri Color from their creative dropdown has a bunch of creative looks that you can choose from. And third, they both have basic correction tools, so if you need to increase the exposure or change the temperature or tint, they have those tools available. And they both have color wheels and curves. So if you need to adjust the color of the midtones, highlights, or shadows, you can do it in FilmConvert and Lumetri Color. And they both have a curve section, so you can adjust the brightness with the Luma curve or the RGB colors as well. And the last similarity is once you're done doing your color grade, you can export it and save it as your own LUT, which you can use in future projects. So those are the similarities, and they both offer a great set of tools that will allow you to color grade. But now let's go into the differences. Let's talk about pricing as the first difference. Lumetri Color comes built in free inside of Premiere Pro. FilmConvert is something extra that you have to purchase for Premiere Pro, and it costs $139 once for After Effects and Premiere Pro. If you want to get the entire bundle, which has a plugin for all the different software, it costs $199. But compared to other plugins, it's actually nice that it's not subscription, right? And then in terms of usability, you can use FilmConvert in DaVinci Resolve, Premiere Pro, After Effects, and Final Cut Pro. And with Lumetri, it's only available in Premiere Pro, obviously. The next difference is input LUTs. With Lumetri Color, there's a drop-down where you can import a technical LUT that will either change your image from, for example, a log format to Rec. 709 color space. In FilmConvert, they do not have this, but FilmConvert does have camera profiles, which in a sense are kind of like input technical LUTs because they will essentially change the color for that particular camera profile for the camera that you use. And Lumetri Color doesn't have that. You do have to either purchase or download your own free input LUTs to use. Another benefit of Lumetri Color that we'll have to give a point to Lumetri for is that it has a new auto button that when you click on it, Adobe Sensei will make auto adjustments to all your basic controls. So if you have no idea what to do, it can do it for you, and there's a strength slider. And it has a lot more basic controls that FilmConvert does not. For example, it has the shadows and the highlights, contrasts, blacks and whites, which FilmConvert does not have in their basic controls. And the next one goes to FilmConvert. FilmConvert comes with 6K grain scans and a whole ability to adjust the grain size of the film emulation. And Lumetri Color doesn't have a built-in grain feature. They just have the presets, but there's no grain. The next difference is in the film stock selection. So FilmConvert comes with 19 different film stock emulations. Lumetri Color has a very limited set of film stocks in their dropdown, and they aren't mapped to accurately display your camera color, which FilmConvert does. So each style that you see from the dropdown has been mapped accurately to each of the 19 film stocks, including color negative, color positive, black and white, and Polaroid. Now each style has been modeled to accurately match the colors provided by the camera itself, and it's coupled with a proprietary sRGB viewing transfer to mimic an ideal film projection onto your sRGB display. So compared to Lumetri, FilmConvert definitely wins here. And lastly, this one actually goes to Lumetri, which has more secondary and hue saturation curves. So there's no secondary or selective color grading options in FilmConvert. So if I wanted to change the color of an existing hue, that's something that I would have to do in Lumetri Color. Now that said, those are all the main differences here, but remember that you can use both of them together. So while you may want to use FilmConvert for those great film stocks, you can always then use Lumetri Color at the same time to do some more selective hue saturation adjustments. So let's go ahead and color grade the same shot. I have this shot here from ArtGrid. It's by Brad Day, and he shot this on a red helium in 8K. So the first thing we need to do is download the camera profile that you shot your footage with. First, you're going to choose the camera manufacturer. In this case, we're going to choose Red. And then I'm going to choose the red helium weapon, and then choose your operating system. I'm on a Mac, and then choose the region that you're in, and then download the camera pack. So here in the timeline, I have this raw clip that was shot on the red weapon. If you're curious to know what camera profile it is, you can just click on the clip, and then from effect controls, if you click on source, you can see the image pipeline IPP2, which is very useful information. So the first thing we need to do is go to effects and search for FilmConvert and double click to apply to the clip. Now I move the effect controls over on the right hand side because now when we click on this clip, you'll see FilmConvert nicely laid out here in a vertical format. So it's just easier to use. So the first thing we need to do is choose the camera. And from here, I'm going to choose red and then helium weapon. And then from the dropdown here, we're going to choose IPP2 and press apply. And immediately you can see it looks a lot better. Now, right now it's just defaulted to the Kodak 5207. I'm actually going to change it to the Fuji 8543 Vivid, and it looks really nice. But we're gonna make a few adjustments here because it does look a little bit blown out on the right. So right now it's at 35mm, which I'm going to leave it at for full frame, but you can see if I change it to Super 8, it just looks far more grainy. If I zoom in here, you can see the grain difference here. That's Super 8, and this is 35mm. Just gives it a more soft look, which is why people really like using FilmConvert. And then from the film size, there's a grain response parameter here where you can adjust the size, the softness, and the strength saturation. And then below that, there's some color correction. So if we want to make adjustments to the shadows, highlights, and midtones, for example, if I want the shadows to be a little bit more blue, I can bring this down. The highlights, I can make it a little bit more red. And you can also adjust how intense you want the highlights to be. And then saturation, I can move this over if I want the colors to be a little bit more vibrant. Another thing we can do is use the curves, and this is where I like to actually pull up the Lumetri scopes, which looks like this. Right now I have the Luma waveform, which represents the brightness. So if you don't see this, you can go to the wrench tool, make sure you have waveform, and under waveform type, go to Luma, which represents the brightness. Basically, we want the bottom of the curve to get as close to zero and the top to be as close to 100 for optimum contrast. So we can use this line here, the Luma curve, to control that. So what we're gonna do is use the bottom curve here and bring this down just around right here is good. So this is the after, and you can see the Luma waveform is, you know, fully ignited. It's exactly where it's supposed to be. And if we turn it off, you can see it's just more washed out and flat, kind of that log raw look that we don't like. So let's turn it back on again and let's play it back. And you can just see it looks really rich and awesome. So now let's do the same shot, but with Lumetri Color this time. Now, as I talked about before, it doesn't come with built-in camera profiles, but you can, from different camera sites, download free LUTs that will convert it to a Rec. 709 format. So in this case, if you're using Red, you can go to the Red website, you can download Creative LUTs and the IPP2 output presets, which is what I downloaded. So from the dropdown, the input LUT, I'm going to select, I'm going to go to Rec. 709 folder, and I'm going to choose the medium contrast with soft size. It does look a bit better, but we still need to make some more adjustments here. So one thing that we can do with Lumetri Color is click on this auto button. So when we do that, it's going to shift these controls over automatically based on what Adobe Sensei, which is the AI, thinks makes sense for this shot. So this was the before and the after. So you can see it just added in a bit more contrast here. Of course, we can adjust the intensity. So if we want it to be way more contrasty, we can slide this over, or we can lessen it so it's just a subtle amount. Really depends on your subjective point of view. But I'm gonna keep it just a little bit above the midpoint here. And then underneath the creative tab, this is where there's the look dropdown. And you can see that they have some Fuji and Kodak filters and monochrome ones and a bunch of other Lumetri presets that come loaded up inside of Lumetri Color. So we can try out one of these. And this one looks okay, but it kind of made it a little bit overexposed. So what we can do is we can adjust the intensity here so it's not quite as hot as it was. We can also add in a little bit of saturation. We don't want it to be too much, but just a subtle amount. Just like with the curves in FilmConvert, we can adjust this curve so that way it can get closer to zero. So we can move the bottom to add in some more contrast like that. I think that looks okay right here. And then there's also the color wheels and match like we did before. So we can bring the shadows down to the blues slightly and the highlights into the red just a little bit, not too much, and some of the midtones into the blue. And there's also a vignette. If you want to make the edges a little bit dark, you can move this to the left. You can see how it adds a vignetting around the edges, just a slight amount. And one last adjustment I would make is maybe lower the highlights just slightly here so it's not as intense and there's a little bit more information in the upper right with the sun reflecting back at the camera here. But this was the before and this is the after. But to really see what it looks like, let's actually do comparison view. So you can see the side-by-side here. FilmConvert just produced an overall more accurate, color-accurate image compared to Lumetri Color. You can see it looks a little bit yellow in the sand and not as vibrant and rich. Overall, FilmConvert, because of their camera profile and color accuracy for that camera, it just produced a better result. And I do recommend, especially if you're filming for weddings or films, to shoot in either RAW or the log format to produce the best results here. So try out the trial with my link below. And if you are convinced, you can use my code PremiereGal to get 10% off. And I am an affiliate with FilmConvert. So if you do use my code, I do earn a small commission from that. So thank you in advance if you decide to purchase FilmConvert. So if you also shoot with two different types of cameras, for example, a Canon and a Sony, and you want them to have the same look, but they have a different color science. Well, actually, FilmConvert created a new tool called CineMatch, which will allow you to essentially match those two cameras to look the same. And I made a full video about it, and you can click right over here to go check that out where I compare my Canon and Sony color matching with CineMatch. And that's all for today's video. If it helped you out, be sure to give it a thumbs up as well as subscribe. And as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.